your short list of things to read over the summer. This book is all about what motivates people. And the main premise of this book are that there are three components to motivation: autonomy, mastery, and purpose. And so I got very motivated by this book, and I wanted to take some of these components into my classroom. So the first year after I read this book, I implemented something called a Choose Your Own Adventure project. And this allowed students to choose from a bunch of different products that they could produce to demonstrate mastery of Georgia performance standards. And it worked out great, and the kids really enjoyed the project, but I really wanted to get some more flow, some more engagement out of the kids. So I knew I needed to kind of take a little bit of a step further past this idea. So the next thing that I did was I implemented a secret FedEx mission. So I selected specific students, and I offered them an opportunity to do a project on a particular unit, say Africa history, but they could do whatever they wanted to in that unit. They weren't constrained by the website with the different options. And then some of the kids decided to accept that challenge, but other students really kind of melted down and had a really hard time not having the structure and the rubric. They just wanted, they came up to me and said, "Ms. Beer, just tell me how to get 100. I'll do whatever you tell me to do, but I really just want to know how to get 100. So I knew that I needed to do a little bit more tweaking. So the next year, I tried something called a learning contract. And I had the students write in what they wanted to learn, how they were going to learn it, their target date for completion, how they were going to demonstrate how they learned it, and prove that they learned it. And we kind of sat down and had a little meeting together and signed on the dotted line and let them go about it that way. However, although those projects were wonderful, something was still missing. I really wanted to see that flow, the kids getting lost in what they were doing and forgetting what time it was or how much time has passed with what they have been doing. So I revisited the book drive, and I kind of dug a little bit deeper into the book the next time I read it. And I read about Google's 20% project for their employees. And what they did at Google was they allowed their employees to take 20% of their time and work on any project they wanted to with whomever they wanted to work. The only caveat was that they had to produce something. So you may not know that some of the projects that came out of Google from their 20% projects included Gmail, Google News, and Google Talk. So without the 20% time at Google, we wouldn't have any of these things, which I thought was pretty interesting. So I realized that the problem was me. I needed to get out of the way. So this year, I sat down with my wonderful and supportive administrator, Mr. Crosley, and said, "I have a crazy idea. I want to do 20% time with my students this year." And he said, "Wow, that is kind of a crazy idea, but you should go for it." So the kids have been working very hard all year long on their 20% projects, and we have a digital program